First Chronicles, chapter 14. And Huram, king of Tyre, sends messengers to David, and cedar-wood, and craftsmen of walls, and craftsmen of wood, to build a house for him. And David knows that Yahweh has established him for king over Israel, because of the lifting up on high of his kingdom, for the sake of his people, Israel. And David takes wives again in Jerusalem, and David begets sons and daughters again. And these are the names of the children whom he has in Jerusalem: Shammua, and Shobab, Nathan, and Solomon, and Ibhar, and Elishua, and Elpalet, and Nogah, and Nepheg, and Japhia, and Elishama, and Beeliada, and Eliphalet. And the Philistines hear that David has been anointed king over all Israel. And all the Philistines go up to seek David, and David hears and goes out before them. And the Philistines have come and rush into the Valley of Rephaim. And David asks of God, saying, "Do I go up against the Philistines? And have you given them into my hand?" And Yahweh says to him, "Go up, and I have given them into your hand." And they go up into Baal-Perazim, and David strikes them there. And David says, "God has broken up my enemies by my hand, like the breaking up of waters." Therefore they have called the name of that place Baal-Perazim. And they leave their gods there, and David commands, and they are burned with fire. And the Philistines add again, and rush into the valley. And David asks again of God. And God says to him, "Do not go up after them. Turn around from them, and you have come to them from the front of the mulberries." And it comes to pass, when you hear the sound of the stepping at the heads of the mulberries, then you go out into battle, for God has gone out before you to strike the camp of the Philistines. And David does as God commanded him, and they strike the camp of the Philistines from Gibeon even to Gezer. And the name of David goes out into all the lands, and Yahweh has put his fear on all the nations.